Hi, my name is Filip Doksanský, but everyone is calling me Fido. I am project lead of the Enfusion Engine, and this is my Q&A.
EF will be modular. What does modularity mean for the engine development team? Do you have your own or third-party tools?
So modularity means that the same engine could be used by more than just one team. We are quite big companies, so we have more teams which are working on the games at the same moment. The engine should allow them to create various games by various ways. It means that it should be possible to extend functionalities of the engine according to needs of the games without modifying the core, so we can still share the same engine for the whole teams. As a proof of this concept, we started a few R&D projects which are going alongside the DayZ, and we are trying to satisfy all of them without any interference. About the third-party tools, we don't have very good experience with that, so we are trying to stick with our own solutions. So we have completely our own integrated development environment.
I'd love more info around Enforce script, language, spec, code examples. Will there be tools for conversion from SQF?
I love this question, thank you, because the script is my baby. The script itself is called Enforce script, and it origins from the Enforce engine, which has been developed by Bohemia Interactive alongside the Real Virtuality engine. It's been developed for many years, so it's quite a proven solution. The latest game where we used the script was Take on Mars, which is completely written in the Enforce script, and there is not any hard-coded game functionality. The language itself is of objective design, and it follows many industry standards like Java or C Sharp, so if you know something about these languages, you already know Enforce. We also developed for it a quite comfortable editor and a debugger, so it's easy to work with it. And as the best example of the code would be DayZ code, which is completely rewritten from the SQF to the Enforce script. Unfortunately, the nature of these languages is so different that there is not possibility to do any automatic conversion. So even for the DayZ, we choose the hardest way, and we did it manually. But it was worth it. The code is 100 times faster, and the scripters didn't complain too much, so it was okay.
How will mods benefit or affect the game with this engine, especially texture mods?
Well, it's not decided yet. With the new Enfusion file system, there are new possibilities, like to overwrite any file or directory, but we need to make it safe against the cheating. Also, you can add or replace or overwrite any script file, which is even more dangerous when it comes to the cheating. So we will have to think twice about it before releasing any mod tools.
How many developers are dedicated to the development of the Enfusion engine?
It's quite hard to count. There is about 6 people here in Prague, which are the core engine team. There is also a few programmers, about 3, which we are sharing with the Arma 3 development. And a lot of people also in Bratislava, which are working on the edge of the engine and the game. They are working on the AI and the navigation. And also we have few people in the R&D, which are preparing some test cases for the engine, so it could be about 15 people.
What are the most significant differences between Enfusion and other 3D engines? What are the biggest technical challenges?
The Bohemia Interactive games were always quite different from the mainstream, and it applies also to the technology. We always targeted for the huge realistic environment and the high detail at the same moment, which is quite hard to achieve. And many technologies outside are not solving this problem at all. With the Enfusion, it's even harder because we want to improve interaction with the environment, we want better performance, and we need much more user-friendly and productive tools. But these demands quite often struggle against each other because we want to make it more flexible and dynamic, but it turns optimizations which are often based on some rigid and static solutions. So we don't compare with other engines at all because we are solving quite different problems.
2 questions. If you would compare a finished engine with a completed Enfusion renderer, which one would represent your engine the most? And besides the renderer, what other improvements can we expect with the completed engine, i.e. collisions, networking, etc.?
I can imagine that from the gamer's point of view, it might look like that we delivered just a new renderer and that's the whole Enfusion engine, but it's not. There is also new physics, which we are using for everything that moves, new particle system, sound system, animation system. We have completely new scripting, AI, navigation. The networking code has been heavily modified, so it was quite a lot of stuff. Some of the new features are still not employed or not working properly, so you didn't saw them in the game, but here in the team we are using them and testing them. So hopefully we will get them to the game very fast, so you will enjoy them as well. So this is first part of my Q&A. I hope you enjoyed that and stay tuned for the next one.